Hey guys, it's Kenny Clark with the Green Bay Packers, and you're listening to the Packer Fan Podcast.
And inconceivably, the Packers have now lost two games in a row, but all is not lost. We are sitting at 3-3, and now we're getting to play the Commanders. All this discussion and insightful listener feedback coming up on your Packers Fan Podcast. And me, podcasting since 2005, I'm Wayne Henderson, and I admit that the green and rose gold tinting on my fan glasses is starting to wear off just a little bit. Anyway, my dear friend Scott Clark is not able to be here tonight. He is not feeling well at all, and it does take quite a bit of energy to focus and use the mic and do a lot of talking for over an hour to record the podcast. So he sent along this message for everybody. My apologies to all the PFP listeners. As much as I'd like to blame my absence on the heartbreak this week, unfortunately, I've been quite ill, actually, since we recorded our last episode. One of the downsides of teaching elementary students is being exposed to 32 kids' worth of germs. It finally caught up to me this last week, and I don't think my throat can handle another episode of recording this week. I'm truly sorry I can't be there, but I leave you in the more than capable and super positive hands of Mr. Wayne Henderson. Here's to the Packers' recovery in Week 7, which hopefully coincides with my own recovery. Go, Pack, go! Thank you very much for that, Scott. Greatly appreciate it. Sorry that you're not here with us this week, buddy, but I am so thankful that you sent along that message as well as your score that we'll go over later as we look forward to the Commanders and your keys to victory, because the Packers are probably going to need them. This is episode 259 of your Packers Fan Podcast, and we need to recap the highs, there was a couple, and the lows from the loss to the Jets, and then preview next Sunday's Packers at Commanders game, including Scott's keys to a Packers victory. And as is tradition, we're going to have some great and insightful listener feedback to share, our weekly poll results, and see how things played out on the Packers Fan Podcast Wager of Fun this week and go over everyone's predictions for next week. Some of the highlights that jumped out from this particular game, there were a couple of amazing catches by Alan Lazard and Romeo Doubs, and one of Lazard's was for a touchdown, which was just a thing of beauty, and I'd call that a highlight. In fact, the Packers leaders in this Jets game, we had Aaron Rodgers going 26 of 41 for 246 yards and a TD. A.J. Dillon, 10 carries for 41 yards. He also had 4 receptions for 11 yards. Aaron Jones only had 9 carries for 19 yards, but he also had 3 receptions for 25 yards. And our buddy Robert Tonyan, Bobby T, coming in hot with 10 receptions for 90 yards. Alan Lazard, 4 receptions for 76 yards and a TD. Romeo Doubs, 4 receptions, 21 yards. Amari Rodgers, 1 reception for 14 yards. And Rashawn Gary getting a sack, which was fabulous as well. And we did get to block a Jets punt and recovered the ball with pretty decent field position. And I personally hoped that would be a momentum changer for us, but alas, no. And the other highlight that jumped out was post-game, really. One of the Jets cornerbacks, Sauce Gardner, he was dancing around in the end zone and stuff, celebrating the victory, wearing a cheese head, and it eventually got knocked off his head by Alan Lazard. So, Alan, thank you very much for stepping up to the plate and knocking off that nonsense by the Jets. Just can't have it, not at Lambeau Field. Oh, the lowlights. Well, we had a blocked punt of our own and a blocked field goal. Oh, and that blocked punt, as you know, was returned for a touchdown. That's no good. Another lowlight, hearing boos aimed at the Packers at Lambeau Field is always disheartening. No matter the reasons behind it, it's just not a good look or sound, as it were. Because, you know, come on, Packers fans, we're better than that. And we do have some injuries to keep an eye on. Randall Cobb left the game in tears, major pain. Turns out it might just be a high ankle sprain, but he is going to miss some time. Center Jake Hansen, biceps injury. We'll see how that goes. And of course, Aaron Rodgers' lingering thumb injury, as well as being banged around all day, couple of sacks at least and knocked to the turf. So Aaron Rodgers is hurting today and probably again tomorrow. And as the season rolls on, we want you to be part of our upcoming episodes by either calling the Packers Fan Podcast voicemail at +1-920-3-PACK-GO, or for the best sound quality you can get, record your voice message on your phone and email it to feedback@PackersFanPodcast.com. Get your feedback in right after the Packers Commanders game. And while you're doing that, please include your guess for what you think the final score might be for the Packers at Buffalo Bills game the following week. And be nice. Okay. The deadline for your calls is Sunday at 9 p.m. Eastern. So I have time to get them all processed, leveled out, and ready for the show. So let's check who gave us a call this week at +1-920-3-PACK-GO.
Go, Pack! Go! Go, Pack! Go!
That was not a good one. Hey, guys. Andre in L.A. Another bummer of a loss, but this is, you know, no need to panic. This is what we discussed at the start of the season. The losses are going to be very disappointing. The wins are going to be very exhilarating. I mean, it's some things that we kind of hit at so far throughout the season is we're turning the ball over way too much. I don't know what's going on with the protection with the line, but it looks just abysmal. A lot of, like, just total confusion on the line. I don't know what's going on. You know, you saw Matt LaFleur pull the team over and talk to him, like, hey, what's going on out there? Aaron Rodgers, he looks hurt. It's unfortunate, but it looks like he's aging right before our very eyes. We really need to look into who the quarterback of the future is. You know, I'm thankful we still have Aaron Rodgers, but you know, our receivers look very disappointing. I don't remember hearing from them all day. Watkins, Cobb, you know, very frustrating loss. Aaron Jones got hurt. Another thing I noticed is A.J. Dillon is not the receiver out the backfield that Aaron Jones is. He's more of a north-south runner. But it was a lot of bad things. Special teams, don't even get me started. Awful. The only, you know, I guess, saving grace is the defense is legit. We have a legit defense. Unfortunately, it looks like they just get worn down in the second half. Maybe because they're not getting any too much help from the offense. But, you know, some good things is if we can just get the offense going, the defense does look legit. Yair Alexander is legit. The line, the front four looks good, but offensively, man, they were getting, is the Jets defense that good? I mean, every week it seems like teams are just pounding our O-line. So, you know, I'm very frustrated. Sorry to be a negative Nelly. It's right after the game, so I'm more disappointed. But Andre in L.A., it's still green and gold till I'm dead and cold. Love you guys. Fan of the podcast. Fan of the Packers. I believe in this team, you know. 3-3, it's still .500, still second in the division. A lot could happen. It's still early in the season. We just need to regroup. One game at a time. Love you guys. Andre in L.A. Go Pack Go!
Love you too, Andre. Thank you very much for the great Go Pack Goes and the excellent voicemail and your thoughts on the game and the team. And like you said, no need to panic. The season is still relatively young, and we appreciate that. You made excellent points, as always. You know, turning the ball over way too much. It's hard to win when we're doing that. And that's one way to look at it on the offensive line, just being confused. It was just weird, and abysmal would be an appropriate term for that. And Rodgers, he is hurt. He maybe should have been asked to be benched or told to be benched for that game to keep him from getting hurt further. But I guess with somebody being paid as much money as Aaron Rodgers and his many years of the team, I guess it just can't happen. And yeah, I'm going to agree with you, Andre. It's unfortunate, but it does look like Aaron Rodgers is aging before our eyes this season. Like it's three seasons rolled into one, and the Packers do need to be looking at who is going to be that quarterback of the future. But yeah, the defense, thank goodness we have that defense. You know, they just get worn down because they're out there way too much. But it is a solid defense, and I think we can get it turned around, maybe regrouping. You know, We've got a very late bye week this season, Andre. I wish it was this particular week. This would be a great week for us to be able to regroup. That would definitely help us out. But like you said, one game at a time.
Hey, guys, it's Mark from New Lisbon. You know, like a lot of Packer fans were concerned after the loss. You know, it wasn't just a loss. We got dominated in all three phases. So, and just to see us get physically dominated was concerning. But I'm not panicking yet. I mean, there are there's, you know, reasons to panic, but I think LaFleur is a good enough coach that he'll turn it around. I'm not 100% sure of that, but I just some of the observations. I think we're kind of running our offense like Jones and Dylan are equals, and I think Jones is the number one, and he needs more touches, and Dylan is a complement to Jones, but Dylan actually got more carries, so that's a concern. I think Jones needs more touches. I think most Packer fans would agree. And without the Pro Bowl receivers, we have to be more creative on offense, and LaFleur is supposed to be an offensive guy, so we need more creativity because we just don't have the Davante Adams to go to. Were there any positives? I think Tonyan had a really nice game. He had 10 catches, and the tight end could be a big part of our offense. So it's go on to beat the Commanders next week in Washington and get back on the right track. And if you're Packer fans, keep the faith. Thanks for taking my call. Go Pack, go.
Go Pack, go indeed, Mark. Thank you very much for sending that in. We greatly appreciate it. And it doesn't feel weird to say we're playing against the Commanders. It's going to take a while to get used to that team name. I almost want to just go with the Washington football team, but excellent call. Thank you very much. Yeah, we were definitely dominated in all three phases. It was messy. And I Coach LaFleur, I don't know what is going on there. And interesting way to look at Jones and Dylan. Yeah, they're definitely not the same. They're definitely not equals. They both have totally different uses in the offense. And I don't know if we're playing them in the right way. But totally agree with you, Mark, about Tonyan. Great game, and it was good to see him really getting more involved. I need to purchase some Funyuns before next week so that I will be ready for more Tonyan action, maybe even a couple of touchdowns, because, like you said at the end, keep the faith.
Hey, this is Dan, a.k.a. Pack Sparrow. I think the Green Bay Packers might want to submit an application to the Red Cross for disaster relief, because good Lord, do we need it. It was just terrible. And can we stop the experiment of airing it out? This is coming down to coaching. 45 passes to only 20 rush attempts? You have to stay the course. Let Showtime and Quadzilla do their thing. The Jets weren't successful in the first half, but they kept running the ball, and they ended up with 179 yards. We had 69 plays to the Jets 53. We should have been more than capable of putting up some points. The O-line needs to protect Rodgers to give him some time. He looked off, and he has looked off the past, you know, 2 to 3 weeks. But I think it's because the defense is just getting in there and pressuring him, and these wide receivers aren't creating enough separation. We went through this, I think, about 3-4 years ago. Special teams surely didn't help. A blocked field goal, that cost us a potential 3 points. There was a blocked punt, which cost us another 7 points when they returned that for a touchdown. The defense, I think, was, you know, they were getting a lot of flack, but in the rush defense, or their rush defense deserves the criticism. But through the first half, they kept them to 3 points. That's pretty darn good. But it doesn't help when the offense does not convert first downs or third downs into first downs. That's why they allowed 24 points in the second half. Joe Barry needs to pull his head out of his backside and stop calling zone defense, because obviously it's not working. Let his talent that's out there on the field do what they do so they can make plays. And like I said, you know, a lot of people are criticizing the defense, but they were 1 for 11 on third down. The Packers are allowing opposing teams to convert only 26.2% of their third down opportunities into first down, and that's best in the league. Not just AFC, not just NFC, best in the league. Their 50% success rate in the red zone is also above league average, but they just can't stop the run, which thankfully next week we face a team that is not very strong in the run. Rodgers had some compelling comments at his post-game presser, saying that it'll be interesting to see the comments from players and coaches and if they're going to be breaking rank and hoping everyone will stick together. I've noticed that there just doesn't seem to be much team chemistry on the field, and from what players and other people are saying that are, you know, intimate with the situation there. So we'll see how that turns out. Next week we have the Commanders, and I do see a small glimmer of hope since they barely beat since the Commanders barely beat Chicago in a battle of the kickers in one of the worst Thursday night football games in history. Hopefully I can bring some good juju with me, as I'll be making the journey to Virginia, meeting up with the same guys that I went over to London with. One of them is a Commanders fan, so we always meet up whenever Green Bay and the Commanders meet up. And whenever the Packers go out there to beat the Commanders, that is. Thankfully, our pass defense is better than our run defense, because the Commanders' weakness is the run. I see the Packers beating the Commanders 23-17. I don't have much more to say, other than bleed green and gold till I'm dead and cold. No matter how terrible our team is doing, I will always stay true to the green and gold. Just because I'm frustrated doesn't mean I don't care. And Scott, he put a comment up there. He said it perfectly in the Facebook Packers Community Fan Podcast. Perfectly said. And then someone else came out with that meme that had the old guy holding the umbrella over the G, saying, just because I'm frustrated doesn't mean I don't care. And that just sums it all up. Love my Packers. I love the fans. I love you guys from the community. Can't wait to hear from Andre in LA, Megan, everybody else. Just, I love hearing all the feedback, even if it's negative. Because we are a community. Let's just pull together, support our team, and go, 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 Pack, go!
Wow, Dan, that was a hearty Go Pack, Go. Oh, good one. I'm feeling better about the game this coming weekend already just from hearing that. It was so good to get your message that you recorded on your phone and sent to feedback@PackersFanPodcast.com. And thank you so much for the kind words about the culture and the group in the Packers Fan Podcast Facebook community. At PackersCommunity.com is the easiest way to find it. And yeah, Scott said it very, very well in there for sure. Dan, great point about stop the experiment of just airing it out, aka hero ball. I didn't realize it was that lopsided. 45 passes to 20 run attempts. Oh, boy. Yeah. And AR-12 definitely looking off. But, yeah, what can he do when the offensive line is letting people in like there's no tomorrow? How can you not be off? It just adds to things and makes it even worse. And your suggestion is spot on. If the offense can actually convert and make some more first downs and let the defense get a little bit of a break, that would be very helpful indeed. And if Joe Barry could stop calling the zone defense, we'll have to wait and see what happens with that one. But the fact that you're going to the game with your buds and bringing good juju with you to the game, yeah, I'm feeling pretty good. We can't take any team for granted. The Jets are better than we thought they would be. And so it's amazing that we lost that game. And then losing to the Giants. I've got a friend at work that's a huge Giants fan, and he's like, don't worry, I think the Jets are a lot better than the Giants. The Giants, they keep winning, but he says it's all smoke and mirrors. So I'm not exactly sure what's behind that. but it is what it is. Thanks again, Dan, and enjoy the game. Can't wait to maybe see some pictures posted in the group again. Now, for our weekly poll in the Facebook group at PackersCommunity.com, as well as on Twitter at PackersFamPod, I'm asking, as a Packers fan, what's your single biggest concern? I know there's lots of concerns, but I want to know which one you think is the single biggest concern with our team right now. And you know what I found out? I found out that no matter how much I emphasize that I'd like folks to pick just a single concern, many just can't. So we did get over 300 votes when you combine Twitter and Facebook again this week. I don't know if maybe when the Packers lose a game or have less points than the other team when time runs out, that people really want to vote and comment, but it is what it is. The choices were offensive line is our biggest concern right now. Defense, Aaron Rodgers is our biggest concern right now. Coaching, and then Hank Davis added the option for receivers, and Scott Boers added another option as well, identity, saying what you are as a team. This team needs to be a run-first team. So we appreciate all that, and the way the votes shook out, it looks like offensive line, quote-unquote, wins in the voting. 41% say the offensive line is the Packers' biggest concern right now, followed by coaching at 25%, Aaron Rodgers getting 22% of the votes, and then 6% for identity. Only 3% of the votes went to defense, and another 3% to receivers. So we appreciate everybody voting as well as commenting. Here's some of the comments that really stood out from the poll this week. GB Roadrunner on Twitter said, if you chose anything other than offensive line, you either didn't watch this game or you don't understand football. Whoa, laying the gauntlet right there. But Steve on Twitter begs to disagree, saying, this falls on coaching all day long, period. Okay, the general manager needs to do his due diligence as well and get a receiver. And Josh in our Facebook group says, I'm ready to give Jordan Love a look. There's plenty more comments on the thread in Facebook in the group as well as on Twitter if you want to check them out. Some spicy comments happening there for you. There were a couple of other great posts and comments unrelated to the poll question in the Facebook group, which, did I mention, you can find that at PackersCommunity.com. Okay, good. Because Bill Gardner shared the latest A Packers Fan Reaction YouTube video. The guy that puts those together is pretty funny, and this one was sadly realistic and yet funny at the same time. So find that video for this week in the group. And I got to say, the guy producing the videos, I probably need to look up his name and know who he is. But he must have home and away jerseys for every team in the NFL, as well as the throwback jerseys, because I believe he was wearing the Packers throwback jersey in his video this week for A Packers Fan Reaction, which is very similar to many of our reactions. Also, an article was posted there about the recent death of former Packer player Tyrone Davis, who was on our Super Bowl 31 team. Tyrone passed away at only 50 years old. Terrible, terrible stuff. And we got this email. Hey, Wayne and Scott. And Scott, I know you're listening to the podcast, so you can hear all the comments from the listeners. Sorry you can't be with us this week. Anyway, hey, Wayne and Scott, this is Caleb, Kathy, and Roy from Green Bay, Wisconsin. What an atrocious game we had. Aaron Rodgers and the whole team looked awful. So many bad no calls and horrible defensive plays. We have to start playing better football. But no matter what, go Pack, go. Bleed green and gold till dead and cold. Always a Packers fan. Always a Packers fan. I can feel it, Caleb. Good stuff. And Zachary says, our offensive line needs some adjustments. Better blocking schemes. The receivers need to catch the balls, run the ball more often, and capitalize on the turnovers. And those are my takeaways. As always, your calls, your emails, your comments, all the support is so much of a part of the Packers Fan Podcast. I want to thank you for that and remind you yet again to join the Packers Fan Podcast Facebook community group. Be part of the conversations at PackersCommunity.com. PFP.com, especially on game day. We have a live discussion thread going during the game, and there's a lot of good stuff happening in there as well, whether we're winning or losing. And hopefully the Packers are turning the tide this week, which reminds me, let's take a look at next week. Your 3-3 Green Bay Packers are on the road to play the 2-4 Washington football team Commanders on Sunday, October 23rd, kicking off again at 12 noon Central. Green Bay leads the series 22-16 and a tie. And in 1932, the Packers went into Boston to beat the then Braves 21-0. The Braves changed their name to the Redskins for the 33 season. Then more recently, they became the Washington football team. And this year, they became the Washington Commanders. But it all points to us winning 21-0 back in 1932. And then bringing back memories of that first ever matchup. The only time Vince Lombardi's Packers faced the Redskins was in 1959. And we beat Washington 21-0 again. Could this be another 21-0 victory for your 13-time NFL champion Green Bay Packers? We'll see this week, because we just got word today that the Commanders quarterback Carson Wentz is going to be out 4 to 6 weeks because of his hand injury. And this is according to Mike Garofolo at the NFL Network. So the Packers will be going up against backup quarterback Taylor Heineke this coming Sunday. And I'm just wondering if they're going out there with their backup. Maybe we should go out there with our backup, Jordan Love, and have the battle of the backup quarterbacks and get them both some game time work. It's only a thought, okay? It's only a thought. Sunday afternoon's weather in Landover, Maryland, which is where Washington Commanders play, for whatever reason. It's mostly cloudy, a high of 67 degrees Fahrenheit at kickoff. That's about 19 degrees Celsius. So weather, probably not a factor. And now, even though he's not here on the podcast this week because he's not feeling good at all, Scott Clark did share his keys to a Packers victory over the Commanders. In the words of Taylor Swift, shake it off. Can you tell Scott DJs school dances fairly often? This has to be this week's mantra for the team, regardless of the goofy comparisons going on here. As easy as it is to think that the world is ending, at the end of the day, the Packers are still 3-3. They don't have a losing record and are still in second place in the division with 10 games of football left in the regular season. With that said, now is the time to have playoff mentality. Scott, did you say playoffs? Interesting. Scott says we need to have a playoff mentality. We're in a must-win situation, especially with the really tough matchups coming up. Don't walk into this game in a slump. Rally together as a team and do what it takes to bring home a win. And his second key to victory, Scott has, this week's practice should focus on to holding on to the ball. Turnovers killed the Pack the past 2 weeks. It's time to go back to the basics and work on ball control. We simply can't get the ball back to Washington like we did to New York and New York. The defense is gassed by the second quarter, so leaving them off the field as much as possible is going to be more important than ever. Key to victory number three from Scott Clark. It's time to let Aaron Rodgers do his thing. As crazy as it sounds after my keys last week, this time around, I think it's time to win this game in the air. The Commanders gave up 400 yards to the Bears on Thursday Night Football. This could be the opportunity 12 needs to hone in those younger receivers. Cobb is obviously out, which hurts, so Lazard is going to be his number one target. But don't forget Dobbs and Tonyan. They're even looking at free agency at this point with Ty Freifogel, who will be at a workout with the team on Tuesday and could potentially at least make the practice squad. Bottom line, this is the secondary Rodgers dreams of. So if he's ever had a time to put his young crew to the test, this is it. And those are Scott's big keys to a Packers victory. Got a new twist on them this particular time around. Good job, Scott. I hope you're listening, and I hope you're feeling a little bit better every day so you can get back to talking, and back to work and all that good stuff. So in our 2022 season wager-o fun, since both Scott and I and the listeners that submitted guesses all predicted the Packers were going to win, and we did not have enough points when time ran out, nobody gets any more points in the contest this year, which currently I'm winning 2-1 against Scott. The listener leader is David Newman, still with 2 wins. Second place, Jay Walters, has a win as well. So this week's predictions for the score for Packers at Commanders, Scott is going with Packers 20, Commanders 17. Interesting, Scott. A 3-point margin of victory. It's going to be close. The heart attack pack. I'm going to go even closer and say Packers 16, Commanders 14. I do think it's a victory, though. So we got that. Scott added this comment. I think this week the Packers are ready to wake up. They've lost 2 in a row for the first time since being under Coach LaFleur, and there's simply no way they're going to let themselves go on a 3-game losing streak, especially with their starting quarterback out with an injury. Heineke's not terrible, but he's a far cry from Aaron Rodgers, even when he's off a bit. So it'll be a close one, though, and in the spirit of Coach Payton this past Sunday, I think the Pack will win with a walk-off field goal. Well said, Scott. I'd really rather we win by 24 points, but that's the way it is. So listeners, remember, when you call our Packers Fan Podcast voicemail, again, that's at +1-920-3-PACK-GO. Right after the game against the Commanders, be sure to include your wager of fun, final score predictions for next week's huge Sunday night game, Packers at Buffalo Bills, okay? So here's some of the listener guesses for the score this coming week in Washington or near Washington. Jay Walters says Packers win 27-13. Garrett Stritzel says Packers win 24-14. AJ Grill says Packers win 27-16. Ooh, I like that one, AJ. David Newman says Packers win 21-14. Alex Bartman says Packers. Wait a minute, Alex. Alex says Packers lose 27-21. Oh boy, oh boy. And Esteban says the Packers lose. Esteban also says the Packers lose 17-10. There's going to be a touchdown from a pick six in garbage time. Oh boy, things are getting spicy here. And listener Dan Dyler, you heard on his voicemail, says Packers win. That's what I'm talking about. Packers win 23-17. And the NFC North is looking, well, it's there. Vikings are 5-1. Packers are 3-3. But below us, the Bears, 2-4, and the Lions, 1-4. The Lions are on their bye week this particular week, so they'll be back in action this coming weekend. And other teams that are on bye weeks this coming week, we got the Buffalo Bills. Oh, great. The Bills are going to be coming off their bye when we go to town. Maybe they'll get rusty like the Packers do during the bye week. The Rams are also going to be on their bye week this week. The Vikings, thank goodness, are on their bye week, as are the undefeated Philadelphia Eagles. So adjust your fantasy football teams accordingly. And remember, Scott does have another podcast that he does. He loves gaming. So the Gaming Outsider is the podcast for you. He does that with a great group of friends. And probably he's going to be absent from that one as well this week, but the rest of the crew will probably be there. And then Scott will be back next week. Be sure to check out The Gaming Outsider at thegamingoutsider.com. Oh, I dream of us chanting MVP for Aaron Rodgers later in this year when we get everybody focused and we're back on track. But the Packers Fan Podcast does have VPs of their own because of value for value. It continues on here at the Packers Fan Podcast. We thank you for your Patreon support of the show. It helps with hosting of the MP3 files, the site, the URLs, recording software subscriptions, things like that. Details for Patreon, as well as the other ways you can help out the show using your time, talent, and treasure, you can find it all at PackersFanPodcast.com/support. Dan Dyler, supporting the Packers Fan Podcast at the Jim Ringo level, is epic. Go Pack Go, and thank you. Savvy? and Jay Walters. Thank you and Go Pack Go for your support at the AR-12 level. Much appreciated. And supporting the Packers Fan Podcast at the Brett Favre level. Thank you and Go Pack Go to Scott Boers, Miguel Ramirez over at the Opposites Attract Podcast, Andre in LA, Jeff Summerfield, and Colm Nolan in Ireland. And Go Pack Goes and thank yous going out to our Curly Lambo level patrons, Joe Christensen, Matt Haig, and Hank Davis from the TPE Network of Podcasts. If you too are interested in supporting the show, maybe even becoming a patron of the PFP, check out the details at PackersFanPodcast.com/support. And word is that the unofficial Packers Fan Podcast is not affiliated with the NFL or the Green Bay Packers. And we do want you to follow the Packers Fan Podcast wherever you listen to podcasts. Maybe even tell a friend or two and suggest that they tell a friend or two, because you remember back in the day, a friend that tells two friends and they tell two friends. We love it. Sharing is caring, as well as following us on Twitter at Packers Fan Pod. Follow Scott on Twitter at GoCastScott. Even follow me on Twitter at Wayne Henderson. And now, as the Packers get ready to head to Washington, a.k.a. Landover, closing us out, it's Mr. Dan Dyler with his co-host from Tottenham, Brett Connor.
All right, this is Dan, a.k.a. Peck Sparrow, and Brett.
Coming in from Tottenham, all the way from London, England. And this is a Go Peck Go.
Go, 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 go.
Go Peck Go!